Where's Gav?
Gav should be back by now.
I hear there's trouble in Roselle.
Clive!
Everyone getting stars in their eye.
Where's my report?
What, no kind words for your old pal Gav?
If it's kind words you're after, you're fishing in the wrong barrel. Now sit down, you fool.
So, you remember how quick the Empire was to occupy the Dominion after the fall of Drake's Head? And how pissed off all the other nations were that they didn't think to do it first.
Half a century of independence gone at the whim of a madman. So much for their bloody treaty.
Clearly the promise of unblighted land and the world supply of crystals was too much for his radiance to resist. And now the Republic's finally decided to follow suit, using liberation as an excuse to declare war on Sambrek. Lined up right outside the Dominion's gates as we speak, looking to starve the Imperials into submission.
And now all eyes are on the Strait of Ortha.
Well, the two nations beat their shields. The rest sharpen their daggers, ready to set upon the war-weary victor. They'll never see us coming. It's time we moved on the Mother Crystals. Four Mother Crystals remain in Storm and Ash. Drake's Breath, near Ironholm. Drake's Fang, in Dalmechia. Drake's Spine, in Walud. And Drake's Tail, here in the Crystalline Dominion.
With the bulk of the Republican army marching to Twinside, Drake's Fang will be left exposed.
That is exactly the move Kupka would anticipate. And if there is anything these past 5 years have taught us, is that he loves his traps. There is one place, however, where nobody will be expecting us to go.
Drake's Breath.
There's a shitload of sea between us and it, and I've never been much of a swimmer.
I have an acquaintance in Port Isolde who may be able to help.
Who's that then?
My uncle, Byron Rosfield.
Lord Byron Rosfield of the Seven High Houses, the trade magnate with holdings in over 100 cities. Wait, Rosfield. And you're a Rosfield, of course.
Oh my god, what a genius.
My uncle's name gave him his start in the world, but it was his acumen which earned him his fortune. Along with a handsome fleet of ships.
Well, it's settled then. What are we waiting for, eh?
New facility. Following height of activity are now available. Oh, that's the thing that I've been getting. Inspiring new is benefactor. This is Desiree. Okay.
waiting for indeed.
Oh, look, another side quest. So, close to you, go there. I'm guessing these lines are the, I don't really know. Maybe they're bridges? I don't know. Anyway. Why did he put me here, man?
So Mather's alright. Without a ship to carry you there, Drake's breath might as well be on the moon.
What's the matter, Nectar? The Hunt Board, it's where the Cursebreakers post sightings of particularly fearsome beasts. Those that might pose a threat to our operations if they were left to roam free. Just because they can't be dealt with when they're spotted, doesn't mean they can't be dealt with later. Was that what you wanted to know? Right. The people of Valestia are going through a lot already. What with the Blight and the war, the last thing they need is ungodly fiends terrorizing them on top of everything else. So if the Cursebreakers are too busy to help, then perhaps I can. Or at least I can try.
Angel of Death.
Oh, Clive!
The patron's whisper. Does that mean someone else is taking care of our friend's donations?
Oh, no. That's still me. It's just Karen has her toll, Blackthorn has his hammer. I thought a new name might liven things up. I still catalogue every item that arrives, in addition to setting aside those tokens of appreciation the sender has specified are to be presented to you personally. Would you like to see if we have any?
Sure.
Come to claim your just desserts.
Then hopefully, yung mga side quests na ginawa ko nun, since I did it before this, baka di sila nagbigay ng renown or I missed out ng renown. Why would I wanna buy this? Okay.
All yours. Here you are. Sorry, but you're not quite there yet. All in good time, eh? Come again. I may have more for you.
Fancy a look at the list, do you? Here you go. Seen enough?
Oh, God, I wish there's a fucking way to travel in this, fucking easier way. Like, Jesus, I have to walk all the way over there.
I hear there's trouble in Rosaria.
I think it's all right to touch him. Can they craft anything?
Clive. What do you want? Don't waste my time. You ain't got the stuff. Bring me the materials, and I'll think about it. And how am I meant to do that then?
Oh, I'm already using this. Right.
That it? Fine.
Yeah.
Come through the forge today. It smells like a still. How much water can a flower drink?
The fuck's in here?
Won't be long now, Martel. See, I was hoping to speak to you.
Is everything all right?
Oh, yeah, it's just, well, as you know, we've been trying to grow fruit down here.
It's good to know that something of the old hideaway still lives on.
Martel's pride and joy. It was a sapling when she rescued it from the rubble, but look at it now. All our hard work's finally paying off. I took it on, you see, after she died, and now the fruit's finally ready to eat. And not only is it ready, it's actually tasty. Sweet as you like, in fact. She bred the bitter right out of it.
Impressive. And welcome news to more than a few, I'd say.
I thought this first harvest could go to the Curse Breakers. On account of all they do for the hideaway. You couldn't take them some, could you? Seems better them coming from you.
It'll be nice being the bearer of good.
Oh, thank you. She always had a soft spot for that lot, see? And once they've had their share, I'll see to it that everyone else gets some. Here you go. Martel apples, they're called, in honor of her memory.
I still need to practice switching items.
Today's finally the day.
Need more practice.
You two look like you could use something to eat. Here, courtesy of Martel.
Martel. Now, where have I heard that name before?
Weren't she the girl from the Furrows?
Course she was. An odd sort, that one. Loved plants more than people.
Aye, and brave as a bane might. Remember when she ran back into the hideaway to collect them trees when Titan attacked? Wait.
These aren't those apples, are they? Well, I'll be. She'd have been proud, and rightly so. Thank you, Sid.
Others weren't so lucky, though.
Hey, have some apples.
A gift from the backyard.
Please take me back. I haven't seen a hideaway apple since. Old Sid was the only one who could stomach the things. He'd nab them right from the branch, made Martel livid. Not that anyone could stay mad at the man for long.
That sounds like the Sid I knew.
Planning on keeping that lot to yourselves, were you? Hang on. These aren't Martels, are they? I'm glad to see someone carried on what she started. Can't have been easy, not in the Deadlands. Reckon she'd be happy knowing all her hard work didn't go to waste. Clive, tell the lad down in the backyard to run some over for me, will ya?
Not so much as a thank you. Well, I've got some manners at least. Thanks, Sid. You can leave the basket with me. I'll see that the others get their share. Oh, and give our compliments to the gardener, won't you?
That was the last of the apples. You should head to the backyard and pass along everyone's regards.
Is there like a shortcut here? I think it's probably longer.
Breakers send their thanks and their compliments. They were clearly very fond of Martell.
They remembered her after all these years. I suppose she was very kind, even to a tongue-tied lummox like me. You were one of the good ones, Martell. She put everything into her work. She wasn't going to rest until we had fruit sweet enough to enjoy. When she died, I named a sapling after her, and now it's a full-grown tree. Martell lives on through the fruit it bears.
And through you. Her dream would have died with her, had you not kept it alive. That's something to be proud of.
I didn't do anything really, but thank you. You're kinder to me than I deserve.
By the way, Otto's expecting some of your crop. And I wouldn't mind some of it either, if that's not too much to ask.
Of course not. I'll see that you're both well provided for. They like your fruit, Martell. Isn't that wonderful? I'd say it's about time we planted you some siblings, don't you think?
Hey, I level up from a quest. That's a first. Well, it's a lot of XP compared to what I used to.
Today. It smells like a still. It explains Blacksmith's foul mood.
A bit torgal.
Do you think it was wise to leave Gav? He didn't seem pleased.
I needed his eyes and nose in Dalmechia. I'm not about to let Kupka take us unawares. Besides, He has a knack for that sort of thing.
That he does.
And wasn't it Cid who said that matters such as these are best left to dominance? Especially should one of his beloved opportunities to grow and change present itself.
I always knew that I would return one day. Return to Ironhome.
For what?
After learning the truth, you were given the chance to face your past. If I am to continue at your side, I must do the same.
The mean girl.
We will face it together then.
To the end.
And you too, Dobby.
Come on.
Bloodlines.
How far do you think your mother's reach extends? Will we find the same tragedy in the south as we did at Martha's Rest?
More than likely. Which is why we should hurry. There are still many settlements between here and Port Isolde. We visit as many as we can and hear their stories. Starting with the village of Amber.
You don't mind, right? What do I go with all this ambrosia that I'm healing a bunch of chocobo.
Yeah.
Wait, this guy is not a joke. What the fuck? Wait. I couldn't see him, the camera angle. I was locked in him. Dude, he almost killed me. Dude, I fucking dodged that. Dude, I'm almost dead.
Hmm.
They're almost dead. What the fuck? Is this the place where the goblins? This is it. This is the place, right?
Deserve a rest. Yeah.
Good amount of potion. And need more practice with Grimmoth. Need like a fucking lifesteal, man. Maybe I should use that just for the heal. That's the only thing I have for heal, right? Wait, what? Then heal me. While also partially restoring Clive's HP. It didn't. What the fuck?
mockery of justice is what it is. Lord Elwyn would never have stood for this.
Quiet, you! They'll think we're loyalists.
Jill, look.
Rosaria must be cleansed of the stain which befouls her, that she might rise once again from the ashes to welcome a new dawn. Twould be a pity to make examples of you all for the transgressions of but a handful.
Of course, your lordship. You shall have our full cooperation.
What business could the Black Shields have in a village this small? There's barely room to hide a bearer.
Then they must be here for something else.
You fancy dancing a gallows jig like the miller's son?
All right. I heard you the first time.